All
right.
my second guy, this is going to come down to, you know, a boxing match. There's not that many weapons in the bar. You can only pick up so many glasses so many times. I'm going to get a bare-knuckle boxer on my team. Why not get John L. Sullivan, greatest bare-knuckle boxer alive? Let me hit you with a stat right here. In 1883, between 1883 and 1884, he had 195 fights across the country. He rode a train from Boston all the way around the country. 195 fights in 136 different cities in only 238 days.
So he had days off.
Yeah. Yeah, they did load management back then. He was fine.
Yeah, Floyd Mayweather fights, you know, once every 18 months. This guy is throwing down, you know, every day, just about, for, you know, better part of a year. Again, just the fight's going to come down to bare knuckle fight. You know, at the end of the day, that's what I want. I don't want some guy that's going to dance around the ring that's going to wear 16 ounce gloves. I want him to be able to punch you in the mouth.
Well, and what's funny about that is I've read some articles about those bare knuckle boxing days, and a round lasted until you knocked somebody onto their knees. That's how the round ended. There was no time limit. It was like until you knocked them down onto their knees or onto their back, and then the round would stop, and then you would do a new round. Like, and that's how the fight went on. Like, it was never, it was just, all right, you knocked him down, next one, keep going.
And doing the research on him, I saw a photo of him early in his career, and then like 10 years later, it was a mess. The guy, he'd gone through a lot, and he
Google
died
search.
At 57 or 59, something like that. So, probably took his share of punches too.
Oh yeah. Yeah. He took some damage. Another great mustache though. Good.
Right.
Good work on the mustache.
What's our limit on mustaches in our team?
Never. There's never a limit on mustaches.
Okay.
There is a limit on goatees. Zero. Okay.
Good one. Okay.